to Hobby Bunkhouse. Created by John Cragg when he built Hollybank House in 1806. On this side we have a realistic orchard, a real orchard, with apple trees dating back more than 300 years. Now we enter the courtyard of Hollybank House. To my right is a tunnel that used to lead to the churchyard. People from parishes all around the place used to come and leave the horses here and then go into the church through this tunnel entrance. If you follow me down, I'll show you the courtyard. It is here that you see Hollybank House in all its famous glory. I believe you are the longest existing resident of Hollybank House.
Oh yeah, I am, yeah.
When did you move in?
About 26 or 28 years ago.
Now, I believe that the house behind Hollybank House was originally a kind of conservatory, if you like. That's why John Cragg built it. It was plants,
yeah.
Etc.
Yeah, yeah.
So what difference is that?
Camellia House.
Camellia House, yes.
Well, he was a devout camellia builder, you know, or presenter of.
Right.
He was absolutely incensed with the likes of camellias. So he built the Camellia House, which is now the Round House. But it's since had a portion built onto it.
And do you think that is John Cragg's legacy?
I think so, yeah. I think he built this place just to be apart from the outside world.
Right here, virtually on the very back doorstep of John Cragg's own home, Hollybank House, is St Michael's Church, the very first church in the United Kingdom to be constructed from an iron structure. He went on to build five other houses in this area and five other churches in Britain. After that, he achieved his life's ambition and his work was done